shocking how AI is detecting aliens. In the search for extraterrestrial intelligence, SETI, we've often looked for signs of intelligence, technology, and communication that are similar to our own. But as astronomer and SETI trailblazer Jill Tarter points out, that approach means searching for detectable techno signatures like radio transmissions, not searching for intelligence itself. At the moment, scientists are considering whether artificial intelligence, AI, could help us search for alien intelligence in ways that we haven't even thought of yet. And that is exactly what we'll be covering in today's video. So don't forget to watch till the very end to learn exactly how AI is detecting aliens. But before we begin, we request you to subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to never miss another upload of the channel. Having said that, let's jump right in. Decoding alien intelligence. As we think about extraterrestrial intelligence, it's helpful to remember that humans are not the only intelligent life on Earth. For all we know, chimpanzees have culture and use tools, spiders process information with webs, cetaceans have dialects, crows understand analogies, and beavers are great engineers. Non-human intelligence, language, culture, and technology surround us to no end. Alien intelligence could look like an octopus, an ant, a dolphin, a machine, or, on the other hand, be radically different from anything on Earth. We often imagine extraterrestrial life relative to our ideas about difference, but those ideas aren't even universal on Earth, and are unlikely to be universal across interstellar space. If some of us have only recently recognized non-human intelligence on Earth, what could we be missing when we imagine extraterrestrial life? In early 2018, astronomers, neuroscientists, anthropologists, AI researchers, historians, and others gathered for a Decoding Alien Intelligence workshop at the SETI Institute in Silicon Valley. Astrobiologist Natalie Cabral organized the workshop around her 2016 paper, Alien Mindscapes, where she calls for a new SETI roadmap and a long-term vision for, quote, the search for life as we do not know it. In her paper, Cabral asks how SETI can move past, quote, looking for other versions of ourselves and think, quote, outside of our own brains to imagine truly different extraterrestrial intelligence. How Silicon Valley plays its part. Silicon Valley is famous for valuing disruptive thinking, and this culture intersects with SETI research. Ever since the US government stopped funding SETI in the mid-1990s, Silicon Valley ideas, technology, and funding have been increasingly important. For example, the SETI Institute's Allen Telescope Array is named after Microsoft co-founder Paul Allen, who contributed over $25 million to the project. And in 2015, technology investor Yuri Milner announced Breakthrough Listen, a 10-year, $100 million SETI initiative. Now, the SETI Institute, NASA, Intel, IBM, and other partners are tackling space science problems through an AI research and development program called the Frontier Development Lab. Lucianne Volkovich, the astrobiology chair at the Library of Congress, described one AI-based method as, quote, signal-agnostic searching at Breakthrough Discuss in 2017. Volkovich explained that this method means using machine learning methods to look at any set of data without predetermined categories and instead let that data cluster into their, quote, natural categories. The software then lets us know what stands out as outliers. These outliers could then be the target of additional investigations. It turns out that SETI researchers think that AI might be useful in their work because they believe machine learning is good at spotting difference. But its success depends on how we, and the AI, create, conceptualize the idea of difference. If you're finding this video interesting up until this point, please take a minute to subscribe to our channel and also drop a like on our video. Let's now jump back in. Smarter than slime mold? Thinking outside our brains also means thinking outside of our scientific, social, and cultural systems. But how can we do that? AI has been used to look for simulations of what researchers imagine alien radio signals might look like, but now SETI researchers hope that it can find things we aren't yet looking for. Graham McIntosh, an AI consultant at the SETI Institute workshop, said extraterrestrials might be doing things that we can't even imagine, using technologies so different we don't even think to look for them. AI, he proposed, might be able to do that advanced thinking for us. We may not be able to make ourselves smarter, but perhaps, McIntosh suggests, we can make machines that are smarter for us. In a keynote at this year's Breakthrough Discuss conference, astrophysicist Martin Rees shared a similar hope, that AI could, quote, lead to intelligence which surpasses humans as much as we intellectually surpass slime mold, the first contact. If we meant extraterrestrial slime mold, what could we assume about its intelligence? One challenge of SETI is that we don't know the limits of life or intelligence, so we need to be open to all possible forms of difference. We might find intelligence in forms that Euro-American science has historically disregarded. Microbial communities, insects, or other complex systems like the symbiotic plant-fungus relationships and mycorrhizal networks that learn from experience. Intelligence might appear in atmospheres or geology at a planetary scale, or as astrophysical phenomena. What appears to be a background process in the universe, or just part of what we think of as nature, could turn out to be intelligence. Consider that the largest living thing on Earth may be an Armorilla astoio fungus in eastern Oregon's Blue Mountains, which extends to 10 square kilometers and is between 2,000 and 9,000 years old. While this fungus may not be what most people think of as intelligence, it reminds us to think about the unexpected when searching for life and intelligence, and of what we might be missing right under our feet. Thinking differently about intelligence means understanding that anything we encounter could be first contact with intelligent life. This might include our first encounter with artificial general intelligence, AGI, also called strong AI, something closer to the sentient computer HAL 9000 from 2001, A Space Odyssey, or Data from Star Trek, The Next Generation. As we work with machine learning to expand the SETI search, we also need social sciences to understand how our ideas shape the future of AI, and how AI will shape the future of our ideas. Interdisciplinary futures. To avoid a human-centered point of view in SETI, we need to consider how we encode ideas about difference into AI, and how that shapes the outcomes. This is vital for finding and recognizing intelligence as we don't yet know it. Some of the methods used in anthropology can help us identify ideas about difference that we've naturalized, concepts so familiar they seem invisible, like the divides many still see between nature and culture, or biology and technology, for example. Recent research on algorithms reveal how our naturalized ideas shape the technology that we create and how we use it. And Microsoft's infamous AI chatbot, Tay, reminds us that the AI we create can easily reflect the worst of those ideas. We may never entirely stop building bias into search engines and search strategies for SETI, or coding it into AI. But through collaborations between scientists and social scientists, we can think critically about how we conceptualize difference. A critical interdisciplinary approach will help us understand how our ideas about difference impact lives, research, and possibilities for the future, both here on Earth and beyond. Is it aliens? The mysterious radio signals from a distant galaxy. For the past decade, scientists have been puzzling over powerful, millisecond-long flashes of energy from deep space. Some scientists think these fast radio bursts, or FRBs, come from natural sources, such as newborn neutron stars or black holes. Others think they could be signals from alien civilizations. One thing's for sure, FRBs are more common than we realized. In the latest discovery, scientists working as part of a $100 million initiative known as Breakthrough Listen used artificial intelligence to detect dozens of additional FRBs coming from FRB 121102, an as yet uncharacterized source in a galaxy 3 billion light years from Earth. The work is the first step in the initiative's grander plans for using AI to find hidden patterns in the bigger sea of cosmic signals that come our way. Research that could finally provide an answer to that eternal question: are we alone in the universe? It's a great way of developing the kinds of techniques that we ultimately want to use to find other types of signals that might come from extraterrestrial intelligence, says Andrew Simon, principal investigator for the Breakthrough Listen and director of Search for Extraterrestrial Intelligence, SETI Research Center at the University of California, Berkeley. The Breakthrough Listen. In August of 2017, the Breakthrough Listen team discovered 21 fast radio bursts from FRB 121102 during 5 hours of observations made by a radio telescope in Green Bank, West Virginia. In their latest study, which will be published in an upcoming issue of the Astrophysical Journal, the researchers deployed a specialized AI technique known as deep learning to see if any signals had been overlooked in their initial research. Seaman gave Yunfan Gary Zhang, a doctoral student at Berkeley, the job of training a deep learning algorithm to hunt for the additional bursts. The trained AI was turned loose to sort through 400 terabytes of observational data, a huge trove containing about as much data as is contained in 40,000 hours of 4K video. After a month of work, Zhang strolled into Simon's office and told his stunned mentor that he'd discovered about 100 previously undetected bursts. To be sure that Zhang was right, the researchers used standard computer software to clean up the messy signals and confirmed the existence of at least 72 additional bursts. The same AI approach could help astronomers find new, repeating sources of fast radio bursts closer to Earth than FRB 121102. If closer repeater sources do exist, astronomers might be able to get a better look at them using optical and X-ray telescopes, says Harvard astrophysicist Avi Loeb, the science theory director for all initiatives funded by the Breakthrough Prize Foundation. "We still have no new clue on whether the origin is artificial or natural," said Loeb, who is not directly involved in the Breakthrough Listen work. Loeb had previously examined the possibility that fast radio bursts come from radio transmitters constructed by an advanced alien civilization, perhaps evidence of powerful energy beams used to propel alien starships. He also theorized that repeater sources such as FRB 121102 are more likely to be such alien signals because natural origin explanations would most likely produce only a single burst. But the Breakthrough Listen team is already looking beyond fast radio bursts. It's developing AI to analyze a wider range of similarly interesting signals coming from nearby stars and galaxies. In this case, AI's broad pattern recognition abilities could prove especially helpful when nobody knows exactly what an alien signal might look like. With that, we've come to the end of today's video. If you enjoyed our content, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Also, let us know what topic you'd like for us to cover next in the comment section down below. Lastly, don't forget to join in next time for more of such interesting content.